Ralphie here, and so are you. Wonderful. Let me see now. Hello there, malt markets. Little clue there. And today, you are at review number 74. Whisky review 74 at ralphie.com. And today we will be discussing something which has arisen because of a number of emails I've been receiving about the cost of whisky. You have noticed quite rightly that the cost of whisky, particularly single malts, is going up and up and up faster than the bouncing share value of a bailed out bank. Correct. The single malt market is regarded as prosperous and buoyant, and therefore prices are going up. Blended whiskies, particularly not the mainstream blended whiskies, they're getting their special offers and stuff, but their prices are creeping up pretty well. And folk are saying, how can we afford to indulge in our whisky hobby when I've got a budget to adhere to? Well, here's an option. Supermarket whiskies. Let me explain. We tend to be sold, and it's the black art of marketing, mainstream brands that we recognise and we associate with particular characteristics and qualities. And when we see them on the shelf, they're all nicely lit up and they're all looking very desirable. And you'll see this in supermarkets as well. But if you look further down to the floor, which is out with your eye level, you will start to notice that wherever you are in the world, be it the UK, USA, Europe, Australia, Canada, wherever, where you have a supermarket, little bottles appear now and again, which are either bottled by that supermarket or are just brought in as a batch because a local distiller needs the cash. Now, this can be quite handy for us, the punters. Now, in the USA, you could find unusual bourbons. In France, you could find unusual eau de vies. In Italy, grappas. But in the UK, whisky. Quite a lot of supermarkets in the UK proportionally, and it's worthwhile having a search around the different ones. I know, I can tell you that the two most reputable supermarkets for quality, unbranded single malts are Waitrose and Sainsbury's. Tesco aren't too bad, but their prices are creeping up. And I have a couple here. Here we go. Tesco's 12-year-old Highland single malt and the Co-op blended whisky. Right. Now, some of you folk in the UK will be saying, oh, Ralphie, not the Co-op, the fuddy-duddy old Co-op. And I say, well, bear with me. I will come to that shortly. We'll start with the Tesco. As you can see, with both these whiskies, they have fake tans. In fact, it's something that wherever you are in the world, when you start to look at the blended whiskies and quite a number of malts and clear bottles all side by side, that there isn't the same colour variation that there used to be. They all seem to be coming the same colour. Yes, exactly. More about that later. So we'll pour a wee glass of the Tesco into it. Don't want to spill any. There we are. Now, this Tesco single malt is described in the back of the label as tasting with marzipan, almonds and citrus notes, and there isn't any flavour descriptors for the Co-op blended whisky, but it does compensate in other ways with this bottle. Now, both whiskies are at 40%, of course. Price-wise, you're talking about 20% cheaper at least. But occasionally supermarkets are quite good at having special offers. And I particularly suggest you look out for November, coming up to important public holidays, important time of the years for people. You can get quite significant and sudden special offers in the whisky shelves because the supermarkets want men who don't normally do the shopping, particularly the older guys. Sorry, I don't mean to be judgmental. I'm not branding anybody. It's just the way it is. Tend to be solitary shoppers who'll go in at Christmas to buy this discounted bottle of whisky, and all of a sudden they'll realise they've got Christmas presents to get, so they'll buy other stuff as well. So that's why the supermarkets do it. This is quite sweet in the nose. It's got a kind of mid-Highland nature. I know that when we reviewed this one, it was a different batch, a different whisky in fact. As a whisky club, it actually stood up very, very well with branded single malts indeed, as does this. In fact, it's good. This is very good. Again, with caramel added, let the whisky sit with the water in it for a good 5 minutes, even 10 minutes, just to calm down and open itself up a bit before you have a taste. What have we got here? I'll go with marzipan and almonds, yeah. That's accurate. And citrus. In fact, it reminds me of Tullibarden. Can't be sure, but that's the direction I'm heading. But there you have it. An accurate flavour descriptor on the label. So they're being respectful that way. Now, with the Co-op blended whisky, it isn't exactly top flight, but it is honest. This is a beefy, immediately in the nose, a substantial, clean, honest, old-fashioned blended whisky, which your granda would happily have had to see in the new year. A very traditional Scotch blended whisky. It's almost something slightly dura about it, which suggests to me White and Mackay, but not quite as sweet. Not quite so blended and integrated. Fizzy, sweet grain arrival, a little bit of bitter, but clean, decent, not much of a finish, you wouldn't expect it, not a problem. Now, I'd like to tell you a little more about this Co-op because it's interesting. When you pick the bottles up, this one is most certainly lighter. It's made of approximately a third less glass. In the UK, 1.5 million tons of glass are landfilled each year. That's enough to build a pyramid in Egypt. The Co-op, because they're an ethical company, and to be highly commended for that, fair trade leaders, they don't exploit the suppliers the way other companies can do. Anyone can be a member of the Co-op. It is a mutual company, so you're not totally controlled by a few autocrats. It's a strong, lightweight, recyclable bottle, less glass, good for the environment. But it's when I turn around and you look at the back label. The back label states the ingredients: demineralised water, blended Scotch whisky is a minimum of 3 years, colour, states the colour on it, plain caramel, cleared using filtration, the closure is a screw cap, and it's suitable for vegetarians and vegans. Let me assure you, multifolk, it's also suitable for meat eaters. I've tested it, and it is recommended consumption information, and very importantly, Braille. So simple, so respectful. Those visually impaired who have heightened senses of smell and taste, how non-costing is that to put Braille on the label? Why does the whisky industry, with the profits they make, not show such consideration, I ask you. In the meantime, Ralphie.com, and I'll see you soon. There we go, Marks. Bye.